Asana's pretty cool. I have some tips and tricks I've learned while using it at work, and I think you guys are gonna enjoy these. I don't know, it's a productivity app, I don't know. So the first tip that I do have for you guys is that if you press Tab Q at any point in Asana, you're going to be able to quick add tasks. So if I do task here, I can then do the assigned person, and I could even set it to whatever project I want. I could set the different properties within that project right at the really quick capture here. I could put files, add emojis, add mention somebody, change the formatting of the description, and add a due date, all like this. And I can even set it to repeat and add a specific time to it as well. And then when I create task, it'll go into this project right here. And then even outside of Asana, if I press Control Shift Plus, I can quick add anywhere outside of being within the software itself. So here's a quick add task I can make in my project. And set the status. And also, really quick, if you want to add collaborators, you can go right here, type in the person's name or email, and then you can add collaborators there as well. So then we see we have a bunch of different tasks that are here. And what if I need one of these to be completed in order for the other to be completed? What you would do is you could take this quick add task and add a dependency to it. So basically, if I would have this task here, cause it so that this cannot be completed, this task is still blocked by a task here that's due today. So I essentially would have this icon show up that shows me, okay, wait a second, the dependency is not finished. So once I finish this one and this gets checked off, you can see that this changes to the normal check mark again. And you can then press mark task complete, and you'd have the proper task order for anybody who needs it. This works really great for something like a specific process that you need to assign to a new hire. Now, let's say you have this view and you really only want to see your own. Like, there could be a lot of different sections in projects in Asana. If you press these three dots here and press search this project, what you can do is find the search functionality in general. So say I only want to see things from the to-do section, because this could be a specific part of your team. You only want to see that. And then even further, what if you only want to see it's assigned to yourself? So I'm going to put Dimitri down, and then you can put whether it's completed, incomplete, or any. I'm going to put incomplete and do search. And then after that, we can do save search, put my project tasks. And now right here, you have a saved search that's essentially a favorited thing, just like how you can take a project and add it to favorites. It creates a whole different saved search section that you can toggle on and off. And at any point, you can go back and refine the search or change the view to a calendar as well. Now, in GTD, you need to have different sections broken out, and Asana can do this really well. I'm going to make a video on the entirety of this setup, but what you can do is you can make a GTD setup by having sections like this. And if you know the functionality of GTD, you essentially put things into the inbox and move them from these different sections based on their urgency and importance. And you can obviously take different things from other projects in order to make this happen. But first, if you were just to make a new task test, and then want to move it between stuff on this page, you can move it to priority one and then assign it to today. And then from here, we can see that these tasks altogether are priority ones. But say we have two different ones that aren't going to be priority ones anymore. If we click on one and control click on another one, we can select multiple. If we do that for another one, it'll keep going. And if we press one and then hold shift and click, it'll get everything in that section from where you started the click to where you end the click. And then you can use this button right here to change it. So like, let's say we want to make it all waiting on, because we have to wait on somebody, or we have the ability to change the project that it's in, or copy the link, or delete them, or do any of these things. We then can move this to priority two really easily, and then change it so that we can reassign them to me, or we can even merge duplicate tasks if there's like a bunch of things that have the same name by accident. And then you figured out how to move things in between by like doing this, or going and selecting multiple within here to move between sections, or even dragging. But how can we do that in a project? So in order to move things around in a My Tasks section, like say you have a new task captured here, the second that it is assigned to you, then you can move it between the different sections in My Tasks. So you'll have to go to change it to priority two, because this isn't due until next week. The unfortunate thing is you can't select multiple and do that section update like you did in My Tasks, but you can go in individually on anything that's assigned to you and change the section from this view over there. Like for example, if we go to My Projects, My Saved section again, can't do that. You can only do it within here, but you know that all of these are able to be edited, so it's easy to just click through them. like that. These are some quick hitting Asana tips. So I hope they helped. And I hope this video helps you on how to improve your productivity even more.